But I usually try to get the lower sodium. Lower sodium.
Low sodium.
Hey everyone, and welcome to my channel. I'm Nikki, and today's video I have a giant grocery haul. So we went to Sam's Club and Walmart. We got a lot of stuff, a lot of new stuff I'm super excited about, some old stuff we haven't gotten in a while, and all the goods. So if you enjoy this video or find it helpful, please go ahead and give it a like and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it, and let's jump right in. So first things first, starting with produce from Sam's Club, which is probably one of my favorite places to get produce, honestly. They just always have the best, and I like that I can buy a lot of my favorite things in bulk. There are a few things that they don't have there. I don't know if they have zucchini. I feel like I've never seen zucchini there, and that's something that I would definitely buy a lot more of. But I got bananas, so we actually have a bunch over there already, but they are getting more ripe and we're gonna cut those up and freeze them. So we needed some new ones to have after so that we have some that aren't frozen that we could just eat throughout the day. I feel like both Adam and I have been having protein shakes like every day now. It's been more consistent, so we definitely go through bananas faster because that's also another thing that we snack on throughout the day. So there are some days where both of us have like two bananas in a day. But anyway, then I got some blueberries. So I like to get blueberries for my yogurts. Pretty much something I also have every single night now. And blueberries are just my favorite to put in yogurt. I just like the flavor, the sweetness. They're always the most consistent to be able to buy from the store, so I just always have those on hand. Then green grapes. So I've said before, I swear they're better when they are in the container like this. They're just so crunchy all the time, but these are super crispy. They're just regular green grapes. They're 0 points for us. And usually that's something I'll have with my breakfast, with my lunch, or sometimes like throughout the day, I just want something sweet. And grapes have been like a go-to of mine instead of like candy, gummy things. I find that they're just as satisfying. So grapes have been one of my go-tos. Adam likes to put like the Crystal Light packet or Kool-Aid powder on and put them in the freezer. That's one of his favorite snacks. I can't really do the frozen grapes. It's a little too much. My teeth are too sensitive, but he really likes that. I got us some pineapple, so this looked really good. I've said this before, but the Sam's Club pineapple is so hit or miss. Sometimes you can tell like it's just not ripe at all. And then sometimes it's overripe, but today was perfect. This is like beautiful. There were a few that weren't so great, but I'm going to be using this for Canadian bacon pineapple two-ingredient dough pizza bake. That is one of our favorite meals. And what keeps happening with my cookbook, if you guys don't know, I'm in the process of writing a cookbook right now. I'm pretty much done. I have everything typed. I have most of the pictures taken. I've gone through each recipe and just remade it, taken a picture of it, and kind of adjusted anything I needed to just so it's like perfect. And I keep adding recipes. So I'll make a new video with a new recipe and then someone will say, I hope this is in your cookbook. And then I realize that it's not. And the Canadian bacon pineapple pizza is one of those things. So we have to have it for dinner one of these nights this week so that I can get a good picture of it and finalize all the measurements and stuff. So that is one of our favorite meals. We're excited for that. 0 points for the pineapple. Then I got some Honeycrisp apples, so I always get these from Sam's Club. They're my favorite. These ones look big today. Sometimes they're really small and sometimes they're like giant, but they're like perfectly sized right now. 0 points. It's a snack that I like to have after my dinner pretty consistently now throughout the winter. Sometimes in the summer, I would eat my apple during the day with like dip or something, but I have found that it is just my go-to after dinner now every single day. And sometimes I have it plain. Sometimes I have it with nuts and more protein peanut butter spread. Sometimes I make apple nachos, and then other times I make yogurt dip with peanut butter, honey, cinnamon, and yogurt. I got some artichoke hearts, so we haven't had these in a while, I feel like. These are so good for pasta, for pizza bakes, for any type of like Greek bowl recipe or sandwiches. 0 points. It's a good filling ingredient that you can include, and Adam is obsessed with artichokes, so it's really easy for me to just toss them in any meal. Like I said, especially pasta, it's really good. Okay, moving on to some meats that we got. We haven't gotten this in a long time from Sam's. This is their pulled chicken. I really like this stuff, and it is only 1 point for 3 ounces, so it's pretty similar to like a kind of pulled pork. That's why I like it. It does have a good like smoky flavor to it. It's 80 calories for 3 ounces, 2 grams of fat, and 14 grams of protein. And my favorite thing to do with it is just to mix it with barbecue sauce and either put it on a sandwich, put it on mac and cheese, put it on a pizza bake, like so many things you can do with this. And there's a good amount in here. It comes in a sealed bag, so this will last in the fridge for a while until I open it. Then once I open it, we try to use it within like 5 days, I wanna say. So we kinda have it a lot when we do open it because it's a big serving, but we are able to make it into so many different meals. We can do like tacos with the fajitas, and it's really good. Then for those Canadian bacon pineapple pizzas, we needed the Canadian bacon. So I like to get this from Sam's Club. I really do wish that I could only buy one of these. It comes with two, but usually you can just freeze one of these, which is what we do. We go through them pretty quickly though once we do open them, because for three pieces, it is 1 point on WW. It's 60 calories, 1 gram of fat, 2 carbs, and 10 grams of protein. And yeah, like I said, we usually use them the most for the pizza bake with the pineapple or just breakfast sandwiches. They're really easy to toss on a breakfast sandwich, and three slices is actually a pretty good serving. They're kind of like thick slices, so we love this stuff. Sometimes I'll just like cook my eggs and then take them out of the pan I had them in and then toss the Canadian bacon and kind of like fry it up in there, and it's perfect. Then I got some ground chicken. So this is just the Purdue ground chicken. This is 3 pounds, so it's a lot. Usually I'll split it in half and use it for two different things. So I'll probably use half of it for taco meat and just add some taco seasoning. And then I'll use the other half for chicken burgers or chicken meatballs or something like that. But it is 4 points for 4 ounces because it's not ground chicken breast. It's just ground chicken. It is points. It is 160 calories for that serving, 9 grams of fat, and 22 grams of protein. So lots of things I can do with this. I like being able to buy the big thing at Sam's Club like this. Next, I got some tuna. So I don't know why, I have been having tuna a lot lately and just making it into like snack plates, or sometimes I'll just mix it with some sriracha and toss it with rice and like cucumbers and make just like a quick rice bowl. But tuna is just a really good high protein option. I think I like it because first of all, it has a lot of protein for the serving, but also it's pretty filling and I just love the flavor of it. But one can is 0 points on WW. It's 90 calories, a half gram of fat, and 20 grams of protein. And usually when I eat it, I eat a whole can to myself. If I make a recipe for Adam and I, we each get our own can. I like to use it for tuna noodles as well. And I do like to get the chunk light in water. That's just my preference. I don't really like the oil and I don't like albacore as much. Okay, then I feel like we've been going through corn like crazy because I keep getting this from Sam's Club. But this is the 8-pack of just cans of corn. It's just whole kernel sweet corn. It's 0 points on WW. And I just use corn a lot, I guess. I use it a lot when I make like Spanish rice, or sometimes we'll just like have it as a side if we're having burgers and we need some type of vegetable or something to go with it. We'll have like a potato and a burger and then we want something else, so we'll have a can of corn or something and we'll just split it between the two of us. It just makes the meal more filling because it's 0 points. So I've been buying this. We've been going through it pretty quickly. Then this was new. We walked by the seasonings and we said we weren't going to buy any because we have a lot of seasonings right now, but then this one just caught our eye and we wanted to try it because I'm getting excited to start grilling again. It's just all-purpose cookout. I feel like this is one we'll use a lot, and honestly I think Trevor would use this one a lot, so that's why I got it. It's just a simple one that you could put on potatoes, veggies, meat. I think it will work with pretty much everything. It says it's savory, garlicky, buttery seasoning, so I don't know, that's just like an ideal basic type seasoning that we would use, and honestly I think I'd even use it on veggie mix. Then we got some guacamole cups, which we have not gotten these in a long time. They haven't had the Member's Mark ones like this, and these are the ones we really like, although they are higher point than the other cups we would get. But these are 3 points for one mini cup. It's 2.5 ounces. It is 110 calories for that serving, 10 grams of fat. It's got 6 carbs, 5 grams of fiber, and 1 gram of protein. And these we use for so many different things. So if we're making nachos, eggs, wraps, or burritos, or like any type of like Mexican dish or anything, we use these cups. Adam uses them more than me, but I do like to have them every once in a while. So this was something new in the freezer section. It is Premier Protein brand, and it is protein pancakes. So I feel like it's probably very similar to the Kodiak pancakes that Adam gets all the time, but we figured we'd try it. Actually, this might be something that we save for a snack review video because I'm excited to try this one too. For the serving of 3 pancakes, I'm guessing they come prepackaged in 3 packs. It's 210 calories. It's 3.5 grams of fat, 27 carbs, 5 grams of sugar, and 15 grams of protein. So that's not bad. And again, these are something that would work well to make like a quick makeshift McGriddle. I think that that would be good. Although it comes with 3, it'd be extra filling, I guess. But yeah, pretty much just says you microwave them for 1 minute and 20 seconds. You can also throw them in the oven, and I bet they'd be good in the air fryer. Okay, next we got some Crunch Masters. So these are the Crunch Master multi-grain 5-seed crackers. And these are really good for any type of dip that we use. Honestly, a lot of times these have so much flavor that I just like to eat them plain because they kind of take over the flavor of the dip. But these are 4 points for the serving, which is about 14 crackers. It's 130 calories, 3.5 grams of fat, 22 carbs, 2 grams of fiber, and 3 grams of protein. And like I said, these are just so, so flavorful. I like that we can buy the big thing at Sam's Club like this because when we buy the smaller Crunch Master bags, we go through them so quickly. And honestly, we go through these really fast too. But They're vegan, gluten-free, and just really good rice crackers. Then I was so excited to see a big bag of hippies again. We haven't seen these at Sam's in a while, and this is my favorite flavor as well. So this is the vegan white cheddar. For the serving of about 20 pieces, it's 3 points on WW. It's 130 calories, 4.5 grams of fat. It's got 19 carbs, 3 grams of fiber, and 4 grams of protein. And they're pretty much just white cheddar puffs, but they're made of chickpeas. And when I like first started WW, one of my favorite snacks was the white cheddar Cheeto puffs, and I would eat them all the time. They were like the natural white cheddar. I don't know. It was like the white bag, and I loved those. But then I tried these, and I honestly like these better because they have more crunch to them. And honestly, I just feel better when I eat them. Sometimes the Cheetos were kind of like greasy feeling, but I love these. They're only 3 points for the serving and really good. They are also vegan and they're plant-based and gluten-free. Okay, the last thing we got from Sam's Club I am most excited about. It is a limited time offering, and actually it's so funny. So like to give you guys an idea of Adam and I at the store, we got to them and we said, okay, I'm gonna scan it. I said if it was 5 points, I was gonna get it, but if it was 6 points, I wasn't gonna get it. And then we scanned it and it was 6 points and we still got it, so. I don't know why we even do that, but we always try to guess what we think it's gonna be. And usually with cashews, it's 5 to 6 points. This is 6 points for the serving of a quarter cup, and it is street taco flavored cashews. So I love cashews. They are my all-time favorite nuts. I could eat any type. We're trying them right now. I wish you guys could have seen the look on Adam's face when I just ripped this open. Can you redo that?
I don't know. I was like...
Okay. Okay, honestly, they don't even look that seasoned. I have a feeling these are going to kind of taste like the chili garlic ones from...
Which are your like favorite ones from
Trader Joe's, but they're just too spicy, which is probably the best thing because I can actually only eat a serving of those because of how spicy they are. So it keeps me in portion control, I guess. But for a quarter cup, it's 170 calories, 14 grams of fat, 9 carbs, 2 grams of sugar, and 5 grams of protein. And we're just going to go ahead and try them really quick. Cheers.
Cheers.
It says the seasoning is jalapeno, sour cream, lime, garlic, and tomato. And I was going to say I taste cheese and lime, but maybe it's not cheese, maybe it's sour cream.
I definitely taste sour cream.
Right? It's like the sour lime sour cream or something.
That's weird. It's kind of like the Quest chips that taste like a Taco Bell taco. It's like that.
Those are good.
Wow.
I think that they could have more seasoning.
They definitely could, but I think they taste really good without... It doesn't even feel like they have a seasoning at all.
Yeah. I would say 8.5.
8.5. I agree.
Okay. That wraps it up for Sam's Club. Let's move on to Walmart. Okay, so moving on to the produce. I got some shredded lettuce. We haven't gotten this in a while, and every once in a while we like to buy some just to have for like tacos, burgers, sandwiches, anything we use lettuce for. But then we also get romaine lettuce. We're completely out right now. Usually we have like a backup romaine when we buy the next one, and then we're able to like transition through it and it lasts us really long. But anyway, we're completely out, so that's why we got both types. Romaine we also use for sandwiches, wraps, bowls, everything like that. Then I got some just regular mushrooms. These I've been craving a lot lately, honestly, and I mostly just use them for eggs and pasta. Also pizza or pizza bakes, but mushrooms have been a go-to of mine lately to just bulk up meals, make them a little more filling. I like to always get us some different vegetable side options. So if I make like pasta or something, there's a vegetable that I can make with it. So this time we got asparagus. Sometimes we'll do like Brussels sprouts or zucchini or something like that, but asparagus will be one of our sides one night. And then sometimes we have leftover that I can use the next day in like a bowl or something. I did also get some zucchini. This is more for veggie mix and to add to recipes that need it. Then I got these shredded carrots. I like to use these in like poke bowls. So like I mentioned, if I do the spicy tuna, like the tuna with the sriracha and rice, I'll throw in some carrots or edamame or cucumber with it and it's perfect. I also got some jalapenos. So I usually don't buy them like this unless I'm using them for like a specific recipe. While we were there, I was just thinking about crab rangoon filling in a jalapeno and I wanted to try it. So I don't know. We got this just as something to test out. We'll see what we can do. Maybe we could even like wrap it in a wonton wrap or something. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, though, that is pretty much it for produce at Walmart. Then moving on to meat, I got some turkey pepperoni. This is just something we use for pizza, for any type of like flatbread or bake. It's 2 points for the serving, which is 70 calories and 17 slices. It's 4 grams of fat and 9 grams of protein. Sometimes I'll just use a 1 point serving on pizzas because I like to add like different veggies and stuff. So usually 1 point serving is pretty good. Then I got some bacon. So I like to get center cut if I can find it. It was actually hard to find today, but got some center cut because it is 2 points for 2 slices, 60 calories, 4.5 grams of fat, and 5 grams of protein. And what I like to do is just make this ahead and keep it in a black food prep container. And that way we can just grab one to two pieces at a time if we want it. And I like to use it for wraps and bowls. This past week, I've actually had a lot of bacon prepped in the fridge and I've used it multiple times for breakfast. I'll just cut up a piece or two and add it to a breakfast burrito. Then I got some ground beef. It's kind of juicy, so I'm gonna leave it in the bag. But this is 96% lean ground beef. It's just the Walmart brand. For this serving, which is 4 ounces, it is 3 points on WW. It's 140 calories, 4.5 grams of fat, and 24 grams of protein. And actually, when I make the batch of the pound of meat, I'll add an egg, some panko, and then I actually get 5 patties out of it. So the burgers come out to 2 points on WW. So that's something we really like to have every once in a while because we have chicken and turkey burgers so much. It is nice to kind of mix it up with those. But then I also just got some chicken. So this is thin sliced chicken breast. With this, I'm going to go ahead and bread it. And then we're either going to do like a chicken parmesan pasta dish or make breaded chicken sandwiches. So I got this. I haven't gotten it in a while. It's 0 points on WW. This is also 0 points on WW. It is 98% lean ground turkey breast. So I got 2 of them. I have 2 pounds and I'll probably do turkey burgers with that. It's actually getting warm enough out that I might be able to grill soon. So I am super excited about that. Adam needed some lunch meat. So he just got a little thing of turkey breast. It's 1 point for the serving on WW, which is 2 ounces. It's 70 calories, 1.5 grams of fat, 3 grams of sugar, and 10 grams of protein. And then I got a big thing of imitation crab because, again, I wanted to do those crab rangoon jalapenos, but then we also just use it for so many recipes. We did a crab rangoon pasta, and I kind of want to remake that too. And it's just something we always have in the fridge because I can just quickly throw a bowl together. Also, when I use the tuna, sometimes I'll throw some crab in there as well. I got some roasted red peppers. This is just the strips. I prefer to get them as the strips instead of the whole peppers. It's just easier to add them to different dishes and stuff. It takes less prep time, I guess, but either works. We've been trying new Ezekiel breads, I guess. Last time we got the flax. This time we got the 7 sprouted grains. So we've never tried this one. It looks really good. It's got some stuff on the sides, which is why we really like the sesame one because of the sesame seeds on the side, but I'm excited to try this. For the serving of 1 slice, it's 1 point on WW. For 2 slices, it's 3 points. It's 80 calories, 1/2 gram of fat, 15 carbs, 3 grams of fiber, and 4 grams of protein. And usually I just use that mostly for breakfast sandwiches, for toast. Adam makes his sandwiches for lunch on it, and we go through it pretty quickly as well. Then just some random things. I got some extra virgin olive oil spray. This is just what I use whenever I make veggie mix or chicken or anything. I don't usually use regular oil or butter. I just really like this oil spray. We needed some soy sauce. So usually when I get this, I try to get the low sodium and 0 points. It's just something that I use for a bunch of different recipes and I ran out like last night, I think. Then Adam's been liking this spicy brown mustard. So he uses mustard on his sandwiches every single day. So he goes through it quickly and he prefers to get like brown mustards like this. It's 0 points, 5 calories for a teaspoon, and it just adds some flavor to a sandwich. Then this has become my all-time favorite queso since Trader Joe's doesn't have theirs, and I don't think they plan on bringing it back, but this is the Pace Nacho Jalapeno Queso. And if I'm being honest, I think I actually do like this one better than the Trader Joe's one now that I've had it so much, and I think the flavor is actually better. And for the serving of 2 tablespoons, it is 1 point on WW. It's always the perfect amount to top my burritos with, and it melts perfectly. It's 35 calories for that serving, 2.5 grams of fat, and 3 carbs. So this is a really good option. I use it mostly for wraps and burritos and stuff like that, and also bowls. Then I got some mushrooms. This is just something I like to just have on hand just in case I don't have fresh mushrooms, or maybe we're making a pizza and we kind of have the taste for those instead of fresh mushrooms, which happens sometimes. But also I like to make my green bean mix, which these are the green beans I like to use, just French style. I try to get the no salt added like this. The Great Value brand has been really good. And I'll do like a can of this, and an onion, and then some Parmesan cheese, salt and pepper. So good. Sometimes I use fresh green beans. Sometimes I use fresh mushrooms. I mix it up every time, and it makes it taste different, but it's a really, really good filling side. And usually the only thing I need to track is Parmesan cheese, and sometimes I don't even use enough to track. Okay, then we've got some yogurt. So I was excited to see toasted coconut vanilla. I have not seen this in a while. These are just 2-point containers of Greek yogurt. It is 80 calories for 1, 9 carbs, and 12 grams of protein. And this is what I like to add my blueberries to and some granola and just mix it up. And it tastes like a peanut butter and jelly because I use peanut butter granola. Super good, super filling, and it's a good high protein snack that I like to have usually after dinner. And it's something I've been having pretty much every day when I have it on hand, but I run out a lot. And so I bought more this time so that I hopefully don't run out. I also got one of these tubs of vanilla. So I like it more in the tub actually, but they don't have the coconut flavor in it. So that's why I got both. For this, the serving is actually 3/4 cup, which is 3 points, but usually I just weigh out a 2-point serving. But for that serving, it's 90 calories, 10 carbs, and 14 grams of protein. So a good high protein option. And it really does satisfy my sweet tooth, especially when I add the berries and granola in. And then I also just got some plain non-fat Greek chobani yogurt. This is for 2-ingredient dough, chicken salad, tuna salad, any type of sauce I need to make. We pretty much always have one of these in the fridge just in case, and because we always want 2-ingredient dough to be an option. There have been so many times in the past where we are craving it and we want it and we don't have yogurt, so we pretty much always make sure to have some of this on hand though. Then I got some Bolthouse Ranch. Also feel like I've been going through this quickly, but I think Adam's been using it more. Yeah, he has, okay. But I use this mostly as just like a dipping sauce if I'm having some type of veggie that I want a sauce with, or potatoes or fries. I use ranch a lot and I really like it, and that's why it's really nice to have a lower point option that I personally think tastes just as good. Honestly, I haven't had plain ranch in a while, but when I do, like if we go to restaurants and stuff, it doesn't always make me feel the best, and this doesn't affect me at all. So for the serving of 2 tablespoons, it's 50 calories, 3.5 grams of fat, 3 carbs, 2 grams of sugar, and 1 gram of protein. And this is just the classic ranch. I still have some barbecue ranch in there, but that doesn't always go with everything, so I like to always have this. And Adam likes to mix this with buffalo sauce to make like a buffalo ranch. Then I got 2 laughing cows this time because I thought this would be good with the crab rangoons to make it a little spicy, especially since it'll be with jalapenos. But this is just the pepper jack wedges. These are 1 point on WW. They are 30 calories for 1.5 grams of fat, 2 grams of protein, and they do have a little kick to them. But then I also got the creamy light. So these are also 1 point for 1. They're 25 calories, 1.5 grams of fat, 1 carb, and 2 grams of protein. These are perfect for bagels. They're perfect for pasta, sandwiches, wraps, anything. I use these for so many different things. And so it's, again, another ingredient that we just always have in the fridge. Then Adam got some cold brew coffee. This is 0 points for the serving, which I want to say is 12 ounces. He likes to just add skinny syrup to this, sometimes cashew milk, or if we have like a dairy-free creamer or something, it's just a good coffee option he can have if he doesn't want to make like a K-cup or an espresso pod. Okay, then I got some taco seasoning. So my all-time favorite is the mild Taco Bell now. I used to get the low sodium, but I honestly like the flavor of the mild better, so I've just been getting that. But this is what I use whenever we make taco meat. I pretty much just use 1 or 2 packs depending on how many pounds I make. For some reason, I've been craving yellow corn tortillas lately. I got them a while back to make chips in the air fryer, which is a really quick and easy snack that we used to make all the time, more at the start of our journey, and I kind of miss it, so I got them again to make. But I also have been enjoying them kind of like rolled up and baked in the oven as like mini enchiladas or some type of thing. But for 2 of them, it's 2 points on WW. It's 100 calories, 1 gram of fat, 21 carbs, and 2 grams of protein. And yeah, like I said, there's so much you could do with them. There's a lot that come in here, so it does last us a little bit, but I'll probably do some air fryer tortilla chips and use them for a dinner one night. Then we got some Taco Bell crunchy shells. So for this, it is 3 shells for 4 points on WW. It's 160 calories, 7 grams of fat, 20 carbs, and 2 grams of protein. And I just love that you can buy these at the store. Sometimes it's frustrating because they come broken and then we just have to use them as like chips instead, but it really does taste just like the Taco Bell taco shells. I just have to make a ground meat, and then I can also use the Taco Bell seasoning. We have Taco Bell sauce, and then we just add like lettuce and cheese, and it tastes just like Taco Bell, but it's fresh and lower in points. We control what goes on it, and so that's why I really like to get those. Then for pasta today, we got bonza cavatappi. I would say pretty much every time we get bonza, we get the cavatappi just because it's our favorite noodle that they have. Some of their noodles kind of fall apart if you accidentally cook them too long, and I've had that happen too many times. So there are certain ones I don't like to get, like the wheels or like the alphabet. I'm trying to think what else we've tried that kind of falls apart, but these always are really good. They hold up well and they hold a lot of sauce with them, so that's why we also like them. For the serving of 2 ounces, it is 4 points on WW. It's 190 calories, 3 grams of fat, 35 carbs, 5 grams of fiber, and 11 grams of protein. And usually when Adam and I eat it, we just split the box. So it's an 8-ounce box. We each have 4 ounces dry, and it is a 7-point serving for them. Okay, and then I also got some Barilla Protein Plus pasta. Out of all of theirs, I really like the elbows, but they didn't have them. But then I really like their like spaghetti noodles and angel hair noodles. So the angel hair is probably my favorite pasta that they have. But Again, it's just a good option that we can have a decent portion of. Usually we have 3 ounces of this, and I want to say it's like 6 points for that serving. Higher in protein, it's more filling, and I think the flavor is great. It's 190 calories for 2 ounces, 1 gram of fat, 38 carbs, 5 grams of fiber, and 10 grams of protein. And that serving is 4 points. Like I said, usually we have 3 ounces for 6 points. Okay, then Adam got some Power Waffles. These are the blueberry ones. So these come in packs of 2. And for 2 waffles, it's 7 points on WW. He said it actually scans as 8, but when you enter the information, it goes down to 7. So that's always exciting when that happens. Usually it's the other way around where it ends up going up. But for 2 waffles, it's 240 calories, 11 grams of fat, 25 carbs, 7 grams of sugar, and 12 grams of protein. And this is a really convenient breakfast that he can just have in the freezer when he comes home from the gym and needs something quick and a tie in protein. He can add some like nuts and more to it and some bananas, or he'll just have it plain, or he can make it into a breakfast sandwich. These are something I've also really liked having in the freezer just as a quick option. There are some mornings where I just realize I haven't eaten and I want to eat something that'll be filling. So I'll grab one or two of these and toss them in the microwave for 30 seconds. They're Veggies Made Great Spinach Egg White Frittatas, and they have mozzarella cheese. They are gluten free. For the serving of one frittata, it's 70 calories. It's 2 points on WW, 4 grams of fat, 5 carbs, and 5 grams of protein. And like I said, if I have 2 of them, usually I'll cut them in half and then put them on a sandwich or something, or even just have like one with a piece of toast if I just want something quick. They're a really good snack and breakfast option. Also something easy for Adam to pack for work. Okay, and then the last few things, I got some Kashi Peanut Butter Crunch Cereal. This is what I use with my yogurt, so that's why it kind of has like a PB&J flavor, because I use the blueberries and the peanut butter cereal. I don't actually use the full serving of 3/4 cup. I want to say that's 7 points, but what I do is I usually weigh out a 2-point serving, which is around 20 grams, and that way it's perfect for my yogurt. It's the perfect crunch and amount, but for the serving of 3/4 cup, it's 220 calories, 9 grams of fat, 31 carbs, and 10 grams of protein. So this is something I always have as an option for my yogurt. Sometimes I'll do different granolas, like Love Crunch, which is another one of our favorites. So this is the dark chocolate peanut butter Love Crunch. For the serving of 1/4 cup, it is 5 points on WW. It's 150 calories, 5 grams of fat, 18 carbs, 6 grams of sugar, and 4 grams of protein. And this stuff is so good. Adam and I feel like we kind of burned ourselves out for like a month or two, and now we're like getting back into our Love Crunch kick. It is really good. It's got little dark chocolate pieces and peanuts in it, and then the granola is perfectly peanut buttery. So we love this stuff. And then the last thing that I got from Walmart was just some Soli gummies. So these are the mango and orange. This has become my favorite flavor that they have. Pretty much just like a real fruit version of fruit snacks. For the pouch, it's 2 points on WW. It's 70 calories, 14 carbs, and it's just a quick snack that I can grab when I want something sweet, or if I'm gonna be on the go, it's something I'll usually pack with, something Adam can bring to work, and I just really like these. That is everything. So we got a lot of stuff today. I'm feeling good. I have a lot of ideas for kind of newer meals that I want to try out, but then a lot of the basics as well. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please go ahead and give it a like and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it, and we will see you next time.
Bye.